Hello everyone and welcome to part two of our vintage style necklace. So hopefully you've all watched part one. If you haven't, I will put the link in the description so you can watch part one. And in part one, I teach you how to make this component. So you should have this made before you start this part. So what I like to do when I'm designing is I like to actually lay out my beads so I can see the colors and see what it's going to kind of look like when I'm done, and make any decisions then and there. So I don't, it's not necessarily perfect. I'm just kind of getting like a general overview of what I think the finished product is going to look like. So I'm liking these colors. I mean, they're very different. It gives quite a different feel to this one. You know, the pink is working, I think. There are some areas where I'm kind of questioning whether I want to use this light pink. I'm going to try substituting out this purple color maybe in one or two areas. Like, what if I had, instead of three of those there, I had one purple one there, for instance, with that. What kind of, that changes the look, although it looks a little bit like it's just sitting on its own there, doesn't it? What if I changed it again? So it kind of carried through the middle. No, I don't like it. I think I'm going to stick with the pinks for now. But yeah, you can always just lay some beads out on your mat and kind of fiddle around until you get something you're happy with. And it kind of saves a lot of time to do this. And also you can experiment with color without actually having to use any of your thread or anything like that. Oh, I left one of them. Let's get another pink one out. So it's a really good way to plan ahead. Oops, what am I doing here? Okay, so as I said in part one, these are 3mm rondelles, and I got these from bbcraft.com, and you can go and check that out. And there, it's a great little kit. You get quite a lot in each little pot, and you get 12 different colors, and they're a very handy size for bead weaving. So yeah, I'm using the pink color on this one. On the first necklace I did, I used this number 10 color, which is a kind of, I would call it like a smoky quartz or something. Almost, I don't know. Now I'm also using some marquee shaped rhinestones out of this little kit that I got also from bbcraft.com. So I picked out, it's just a mixed set of colors, so you don't know what you're gonna get. So you just have to kind of play with what you get until you're happy with it. I do actually have another of these red ones, but I like, oh, I like that, that's nice. I like it not all being the same. You know, I like having two different colors there. Just, you know, nature is kind of random, so I like to be a little bit random. And then the other thing you're going to need, 18 3mm beads, pearls, and you're going to need these are 4mm pearls, so you're going to need 18 of them, 4mm. And then you're going to need 3 6mm pearls. And I don't know how many of these rondelles, I haven't counted. And then you're going to need 4 of your marquees. You're also going to need a chain. I'm using a finished chain with a clasp on it. And what I will do is I will cut this to the right length and attach it with a jump ring. And you're going to need some wire guardians. So if you don't know what those are, they're a little loop with a little hole on each side, and you can sew your thread up and around and back down, and it kind of, it's like a piece of metal so instead of just having a thread, you actually have a piece of metal there to join onto. And then you'll need some jump rings just to hook your chain on. You will also need your 50 O's that you were using on the central motif, but you do not need your 11 O's anymore. So we're just using 15 O's for this. And I am using Wildfire 10 pound. Sorry, let me get that label off. I've had this for a long time. I hardly ever use this. I actually bought this when I lived in the UK, and I've been living in America for over 3 years now, so that tells you how little I use. Look how much I've still got on the spool, just because it's so thick, and most of what I do is bead weaving. So yeah, this is 10 pound Wildfire, and you're going to need 2 beading needles for this, because we're going to start down at the bottom, and then we're going to kind of go up and along and back down. So get yourself 2 beading needles, and let's get started. Okay, so I cut about a wingspan is what I like, hold both arms out and like as much thread as I could hold, so sort of 5.5 feet, probably maybe 5, and that's how much thread I have cut. And then on each end, I've threaded a beading needle, and I've made sure that my tails are even to each other, so they finish in the same spot. So you can just grab your needle and like pull up or down. And then just run your finger down and find the middle. And when you run, if you're using Wildfire, it will like kind of leave a kink, so you'll know where the middle is. So for the beginning, we're going to pick up, we're going to pick up one of our 6 millimeter pearls, and we're going to push that down to the middle of our thread. Let's get that centered, and then the 2 little leaves that you want at the bottom of the necklace, whichever way you want them. We're going to pick one up on one needle, going through a pair of the holes. So you've got 2 sets of holes on these. If you look on the side, you can either go through the front or the back. So we're just going to go through what we would consider to be the bottom ones. So pick that up. Pick the other one up. If they want to turn upside down, that's fine. Get your 2 needles together and then just push down to try and get that as centered as you can for now. Okay. Then we're going to pick up 3. Hang on, let me just count. 4. 4 of our 15 O's on each needle. I've got mine twisted around. There we go. Okay, so 4 of our 15 O's. So 1, 2, 3, 4 on the first needle. And you're just going to go through the other hole on the side that you're coming out. Okay, so through the other hole. and then you're going to go through the other hole of the opposite marquee as well. Okay, so that's created on the side there, which has got some little beads. Put that needle down and do the same on the other side. And it might be a little bit tricky at this point, just managing your threads, so just be patient. So four of our 15-0s, and then go into the other hole, and then through that the marquee again, the other marquee shape. Okay, so this thread is coming out this hole here, I'm going into that hole and coming out the top. Okay. So then when you pull it, that is now on that side and the other needle is on that side. So you should have something that looks a bit like this. Okay. And I'm just going to grab my two needles together again, and I'm going to make sure that that is roughly centered, and if it isn't, you can, like, I need a little bit more on that side, so I'm loosening that, and then you can kind of see what you need to loosen or tighten to get it roughly in the center. It doesn't have to be exact, but okay, that's pretty good. So, all right, now let me get my needles back on each side that I'm going to be working on. Okay. All right, so now we are going to pick up four more of our 15-0s on each needle. So four on this one, and one, two, three, and so you've got four on each needle, and push those down, and then you're going to go up one of your pink or whatever color you're using 3 millimeter rondelles. So go that one. Getting caught on the other necklace. 1 second. Okay, just push that down almost to the bottom, and then you can go through it in the same direction. So you're not crossing them. They're both going upwards through both of them. So your two threads should be coming out of the same end of the rondelle, okay? And just push that down as hard as you can. Okay. And don't worry if it's kind of rocking forward right now. It actually sits fine when you're wearing the necklace. So just try and squish that down. Okay. Now, if I were you, I would put one of your needles to the side at this point and only work with one of them. Let me just see. I want to make sure that my threads are not crossed, so I'm going to loosen this and see which. Okay, so this is this needle. So I want to keep my left hand needle on my left hand side. So I'm just going to stab it into my bead mat on this side. And it's going to stay over there while I'm working with my right hand needle. Okay. Alright. This is the hardest part, really, is getting this started. Okay. So I'm pulling my two apart just to keep that even for now, and then you can just put your finger on it. Okay, so then you're going to pick up four more of your 15 O's. So pick up 4 on whichever needle you're working with at the moment and go on down. And then I know that I want this crystal to be at the bottom of my necklace. So I am going to enter into the 15 O, the crystal, and then the next 15 O. So the 15 O, the rondelle, and the next 15 O. Hang on, let me try and zoom in for you, okay? So the one that's kind of underneath this. And then I'm going to pass through the next crystal. If I can find the hole for it. There we go. And then through the next 15-0. I'm going through the wrong 15-0 here. I'm just going to go through that. Through the next 15-0 crystal and 15-0. Okay. And I'm going to stop right there. I'm just going to pull that, make sure that's nice and tight. Then I'm going to pick up my left needle. And I'm going to do exactly the same thing. So I'm going to pick up 4 of my 15 O's. And then I'm going to head into the 15 O that's here next to this rondelle, through the rondelle and the 15 O. Looped around. There we go. All right. And don't worry, if this is like turning backwards, we're going to fix that when we come back down in a minute. Okay, so that's nice and tight. Then I'm going to carry on through the setting and then through the next 15-0 rondelle and 15-0. Okay, so I am now in position with each of my threads to start working the branches of my necklace here. One thing I forgot to mention, here I stopped and I obviously used a chain, but if you want, there is no reason you could not carry on and do a beaded chain if you want to. You don't have to use these wire guardians. You could just do like a loop and another loop and kind of form some kind of chain, beaded chain. This is just how I did it because it, you know, I don't have time to bead an entire chain and I kind of like the way this looks and it's adjustable. So, but if you want to make it fancier, by all means, make it fancier. Okay, so we're going to just work on the right-hand side for now. So what we're going to do is we're going to pick up one of our 4mm pearls, then our marquee, and so if we wanted it to be sitting like this, we're going to go through this hole so that it's the nearest to us in an upwards direction to get it in the right direction. Okay. And then we're going to pick up another pearl. And we're going to go into this 15-0 rondelle and 15-0. So the next one over from where we were a minute ago. Okay, so there we go. And then actually, we're not done with the other thread yet. I forgot. Okay, we're going to do the same on the other side. So you're going to pick up your pearl, then you're going to go through the bottom to the top of your marquee, and then you're going to pick up your purl again, another purl, and then you're going to go through the 50 now, the rondelle, and the 50 now. Pull that, and then we're going to cross these two threads through this top setting, and I'm carrying on through the 15-0 just because my needle wants to. That's absolutely fine. That's our next move. So if your needle wants to do that, just go ahead and let it. Otherwise, continue on through the 15-0, the rondelle, and the 15-0. I've got looped around that somehow, I believe. Have I? Yes. Okay. Just make sure you don't get looped there. Okay. So this needle that I'm still using, which just fell. Okay. The same needle. Then you can carry on up through your purl. And through the base of the marquee. Okay. And just set that one off to the side. And pick up your other needle. So we're basically, we're crisscrossing across the top our needles because I want this base to be on the other thread. And then we build upwards from here. So this needle, like, we do the same thing. We go through that top setting. I don't like where I'm coming out. Don't want to go through that bead. Okay, there we go. So go through the top and then through your 15-0, your rondelle, your 15-0, and through the purl and through your crystal. Okay. And that one's on that side. So what we have now done is we've got just the very first bit in place, and we're coming out on each side the bottom of our marquees. And this is twisting, but that's fine. Okay, so we're coming out. Each of our threads should be coming out here. So all you've done is you've gone up around and come out here, and this one's gone up around and come out here. Okay, I hope this is clear. Okay, so we're just going to be working with our right hand thread for now. The left hand side is exactly the same, just the opposite. So what you're going to do is you're going to pick up two 15-0s, one of your rondelles, and two 15-0s. And you're going to go through the second hole of this marquee. Okay. And if that, if it's coming a little loose right here, you just pull the opposite thread because that's the one that controls the tension there. Now we're going to pick up we're going to pick up a 15-0, a 4mm purl, if I can find the hole, there we go, another 15-0, another 4mm pearl, another 50 now, another 4mm pearl, I don't know why I have such trouble saying that, and one more 50 now. So this is what we've got on our thread, on our needle. And you're going to go through the same hole that you just went through on the marquee. Okay, so you've got that. And then you're going to pick up 2 15-0s, a rondelle, and 2 15-0s. Again. And go through this hole on the marquee on this side. And then continue, well, my needle's automatically gone through, continue up through the 2 15-0s there. Through the rondelle. Through the 2 15-0s here, through the marquee. And then you're going to go up through the 15, the pearl, the 15, and the next pearl. Okay, and now what we're basically doing here is, it's right angle weave, but we just got some 15-0s in between things. So what we're going to do is we're going to pick up a rondelle, a 15-0, a rondelle, and a 15-0, and a rondelle. So, rondelle 15, rondelle 15. And we're coming out this side of this pearl. We're going to enter into this side of this pearl. And pull that. Then continue on up through the rondelle, the 15-0, and the next rondelle. And just try and keep this as tight as you can at this point. So snug everything up before you do your next thing. Okay, so just like we just did, we're going to put, this time we're going to pick up a pearl and then a 15-0, a pearl, a 15-0, and a pearl, and a 15-0 on the end. So you should have 3 pearls with 2 15-0s in the middle. And again, you're going to go through your rondelle. Snug that up. Then you're going to continue on up through your pearl, through the 15-0, and the next pearl. So, we now have this. Okay, so now we're going to pick up a rondelle, if I can find the hole, a 15-0, a rondelle, a 15-0, and a rondelle. So again, 3 rondelles, 2 15-0s. We're going to go down through this pearl that we're exiting out of right now. Okay, so we have this. Then we're going to go up through the rondelle, the 15-0. And we're going to stop right there, coming out of this 15-0. Okay, so we are now going to pick up 4 of our 15-0s. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay. And we're going to pick up a 6mm pearl. Okay. Now we're going to get our wire guardians, one of our wire guardians. You're going to go up through the wire guardian from the bottom of the horseshoe side. So go up. And then you're going to go back down through the other side. And when we pull our thread, it's gonna sit in this little channel right here. And we're gonna pull it right down until we get to the pearl. And now I'm gonna sew back down through the pearl. Right now my wire guardian is kind of open, so my thread is not going, see how there's a gap? My thread is not actually touching there. So I'm going to get some pliers. And I like to use these crimping pliers. They're great. I use them for everything. All I'm going to do is very, very gently, just gently squeeze. And because what I don't want to do is squish this channel. They're very delicate and you don't want to squish it. So I'm just gently kind of squeezing it together a little bit, telling it, hey, go that way. Okay. All right. That's pretty good. It doesn't have to be exactly together. And when I pull, then it kind of sits more down on the pearl. I can maybe squeeze that a little bit more. So yeah, just kind of nudge it a little bit until it's where you want it to be. But yeah, be very, very gentle. You don't want to be heavy-handed with this. It's not exactly together, but it's good enough. Okay, so pull that all of that just to snug, make sure everything is snugged up there, nice and tight against the pearl. And then you're going to pick up 4 more of your 15 O's. So 4 more 15 O's. And you're going to go into this 15 that's right here, and this rondelle, and pull that. Okay. Now, I like to reinforce, so I'm going to go back through the pearl again, and I'm going to go all the way up and around again in the following the same path. So I'm going to go up all these 15 O's into the pearl, if I can get in, which I can't. Okay, that's all right. Just take as many steps as you need to do this. Then go up through the pearl. Then I'm going to enter, you might need to bend your thing away from you in order to get into the bottom of it. Come on, there we go, I got it. And this is why you don't want to squish the channel here, because you won't be able to get your needle up again. And then go back down the other side and down through the pearl and just make sure that thread sits in the channel nicely, and then go back down here. Back down through your rondelle. Okay, and now I'm going to just snake my way back down following the right angle weave, so through that 15-0, through the purl, sorry, I bumped you, through the rondelle, through the 15-0 and the rondelle, through the purl. So because I'm using this 10-pound thread, this is actually going to be really strong. Down through, when you get here, remember you've got an extra 15-0 there that you'll need to go through. Okay, then we're going to go through the marquee. I can find the hole. There we are. Through the marquee. Then up through these 15-0s. And this rondelle. And these 15-0s. Through the marquee again. But I don't want to go through the 15-0s on the other side, which I'm having trouble not going through them. Okay, I'm just gonna sew backwards through it when I get through. Sometimes it's easier just to do that. If your thread definitely wants to go through something, it's easier to just let it and then go back. Okay. And then through the purl. And just to anchor it onto the base, I'm going to go through the 15-0 and the marquee, rondelle and the 15-0, just to leave my thread here ready for the next bit. Okay, so we've done one branch. So the other branch is exactly the same. So you're going to pick up your two 15-0s, your rondelle, your three purls, it was separated each time by a 15-0. Go back through here, and then you're going to go up, and then you're going to add on your sections. So you should have two sections, one and two with purls, which are the one immediately after, and two with rondelles. Then up, round, and then back down. So if you need to rewind the video, just do that at this point. Do exactly the same on this side. And I will see you back in a minute. We're going to sort this bottom section out, and then we will be finished. So I'll see you in a minute. Okay, so hopefully you've gone and you've done this side now. So I've done both of them, and both of my threads are coming out of the 15-0 after the rondelle on the base. So we're going to travel both threads down. Let's work on the right hand side first. So I'm just going to continue on through the setting. And if you're having trouble getting through these beads here, because I know this thread is thick, and obviously when we made this central section, we did go through a few times. So if you're having trouble, it might help if you swap to a thinner needle. I had to do that when I made my first necklace. I swapped down to a thinner needle. And you may have to squash the end of your wildfire with pliers in order to thread it. Okay, so now I'm going through the 15-0 here. I'm going to go through the rondelle and through the next, can't remember if it's the next one or two. Let me just have a quick look. Through the next, just through the next one, 15-0. So just the one on the base that we are using, in other words. Then we're going to pick up our 4mm purl, because you should have two left. If you started with 18, you should have two left. And then we're going to pick up 3 15-0s. And here, make sure it's facing the correct direction here. We are going to enter into the, not the first bead after the rondelle, but the second bead. So you're going to go down these three and then just continue down through all of these 15s down the side here. Okay, so it should look like that. And keep going until you come out. From the bottom 15, okay? And then you can put that needle to the side for a minute, and we're going to do exactly the same on this side. So we're going to go down through the next setting, the beads are in the way such that I can't even get the right angle. Okay, there we go. I'm also going through the 15-0 there. And then through the rondelle and just the next one 15-0. A little tight for me, so I'm trying to be gentle. Don't want to pop a bead. There we go. All right. Now you're going to pick up your other 4mm purl, and then you're going to pick up 3 15-0s. And you're going to go into the, not the one immediately after the rondelle, but the one after that. And then you're going to go all the way down through all of those 15-0s. So give that a nice tug. Go down through all the 15-0s. Get in. Okay, there we go. Nope, I'm not in. Oh, goodness me. There we go. Okay. All right. So we're now coming out from the bottom of our 15-0s. So just make sure that you pull both of those. That one's twisting a little weird for some weird reason. I don't know why. Hopefully that will straighten out. So try and get them to sit nicely. Okay. All right, so now all we have to do is tie off and we're done. So to do that, what I do is I go through one of these marquees here. Ouch, and I poke myself like that. It's one of the hazards of beading, poking yourself with a needle. I'm so used to it now. Okay, and then with the other needle, we're also going to go through the marquee, and I'm going to go through the pearl as well. Okay, and again, I'm just going to check that I'm happy with tension and so forth. I think that's good. And then I'm going to tie a square knot right here with these two threads. So the way you do that is you put your right needle over your left and pull it under. And then put your left needle over your right and pull it under. Okay, and then all I need to do is just sew back through the marquee on this side and up some of these 15-0s. And I can cut that thread off. And then with the other needle, I just go back through the pearl. And the marquee. To find the hole, there we go, and up some of these 15-0s. And then I can cut that thread off. Excuse me. Okay. All right, so we finished the bead weaving portion. So now what I do is I get my measuring tape and I see how long this is. And I am measuring this in inches. So it's approximately 4 inches. So if I know I want to make my necklace 17 inches, so I'd subtract 4, so that's 13. Half of 13 is 6.5. Now, this is actually an adjustable necklace here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to measure 6 inches from where the actual chain starts, which will give me 12 full inches of necklace. So just match up where your chain, the actual chain portion starts. Lay it out nice and even. Make sure that your links are lined up 1-to-1. Okay, so I'm going to measure 6 inches. So about here. Is where I'm going to cut. So I'm just going to hold my finger there for a second. And then I'm going to get my wire cutter. And I need one of these loops to be at the bottom. I'm actually going to cut a little less because there is such a long extension. So I'm going to cut on my chain on this figure eight right here because I need one of these big loops to join. Alright, so that's good. And then I'm going to measure again the other side. So all I'm doing is lining up my chain. And now I can see exactly which link I need to cut, which is right here, this figure eight. So I'm gonna cut that. Okay. And this extra bit I will keep and I will use it in something else because I can use that in an earring or for a bracelet or something. So I always keep all my little offcuts of chain. You never know when you're gonna need them. And that's quite a good size bit. Now the next thing that I think about is I always want my clasp to be on the right when I'm doing up my necklace, which means if you're looking at the necklace, it's on the left-hand side. So I want it like this. So what I will do is I will grab two jump rings and then I'm just going to attach one here and one here. So I don't want them to be too big, so I'm just going to use these. I think they are probably 4 millimeter. And I'm just going to check that they can close nicely and are all straightened. Wonderful. So these ones are quite small, but they're nice and thick, which is what I like about them. They're sturdy. If you square off your jump ring a little bit I like to squeeze it like that, so it's a little bit squared off right there. It actually helps with the strength as well. I've got a little sharp bit on there. Might have to file that. Anyway, okay, so I know it's going to close nicely. I can see that the join is closed. So once I've done that, I twist it open, put it through my wire guardian, and my chain. And then I just twist it back closed again, give it a little wiggle. Quite straight. And again, I like to kind of flatten the join with my pliers. Here we go. Yeah, that's good. Okay, so that side's on. And I'll just do the other. And then my necklace will be ready to wear. So yeah, if you want, you can totally bead a chain. It's entirely up to you. You'll just have to add more thread and then, you know, kind of just continue to add more as you need it. And if you wanted, you could use like a brass chain, you know, like an aged looking chain. Or gunmetal, and use like dark seed beads. That would be really cool as well. That would make a really vintage looking kind of necklace. I just decided to use the silver because I did. I don't know why. Okay, there we go. It's finished. So here's my necklace all ready for me to wear, and this will settle down and lie. It does lie nicely on your neck, so And here's, that's the one we've made during this video series. And that's the previous colorway that I did. So, with the more blues and greens. But it's very pretty. I really like the way it's come out. And I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I hope it inspires you. If anything, I would say go to bbcraft.com and get this set of rhinestones, because you get so many in here. I mean, I can make a lot more projects out of all this. It's a very good value for money, and they're really pretty, if you like this kind of vintage style. So, yeah, I hope you've enjoyed the video. If you're not a subscriber, I'd love it if you want to subscribe. I try and do a video a week. Sometimes it's 2 weeks, but yeah, I try and do approximately one a week. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!